Hello, welcome to another GoJS intermediate tutorial. This video will explain and demonstrate how to use LayeredDigraphLayout, an automatic layout that ships with GoJS, used to arrange nodes into layers in rows or columns. If your graph is tree structured, you may be more interested in tree layout. We have a video on that layout too. Using GoJS requires programming in JavaScript and familiarity with HTML and CSS. Additionally, this video assumes you understand the basics of GoJS, which are covered in the GoJS Beginner Videos series. Before we start, note every pre-built GoJS layout has a live sample on GoJS.net. These samples allow one to interactively and visually learn about commonly used properties for each layout type. As always, extensive coverage of these properties and behaviors can also be found in the full API documentation on GoJS.net. We'll explore layered digraph layout by way of example. This layout arranges nodes of directed graphs into layers, horizontally or vertically. This layout handles links that form cycles better than tree layout does. That said, if your links and nodes are structured in a tree-like fashion, it may be better to use tree layout, which is faster than layered digraph layout. Let's add some new node and link data to our model without setting the layout yet. Load the page, just so you can see what these nodes and links look like without being laid out. Now, go back and set our diagram's layout to a fresh layered digraph layout, then reload the page. We see now the nodes are arranged in layers based on how they are connected. Let's see how we can modify our layered digraph layout. We'll start with the direction property. The direction property gets or sets the direction the graph grows towards. 0 is to the right, 90 is downwards, 180 is to the left, and 270 is upwards. The default value is 0. Let's set direction to 90 and reload the page. We now see our graph grows downward. The layered spacing and column spacing properties control the distance between layers and the size of each column within a layer in document coordinates, respectively. Values for these properties must be positive numbers. The default value for both layer spacing and column spacing is 25. Set the layer spacing property to 50, twice the default value. Set the column spacing property to 100. Reload the page. We see the layers of the layout have more room between them, and the room between the nodes in each layer is very large, since the size of each column is now 100, and each column holds one node. We can set both these properties back to their default values of 25. We'll now observe the layering option property of layered digraph layout. This property gets or sets which layering option is being used. This determines how the nodes in the layout are assigned to their layers. The default value is layeredDigraphLayout.layerOptimalLinkLength. Other possible values are layeredDigraphLayout.layerLongestPathSync and layeredDigraphLayout.layerLongestPathSource. LayerLongestPathSync assigns layers using LongestPathSync layering. A sync node is defined as a node with no links leaving it. With this layering option value, every sync node appears in layer 0, and every node is placed as close as possible to a sync. Let's set the layering option property of our layered digraph layout to go.layereddigraphlayout.layerLongestPathSync, then reload the page. We see our sync nodes, nodes without links leaving them, epsilon and gamma, are both in layer 0, the lowest layer since our graph grows downwards since we set the direction property to 90 earlier. All other nodes are as close to epsilon or gamma as they can be. LayerLongestPathSource assigns layers using LongestPathSource layering. A source node is defined as a node with no links entering it. With this layering option value, every source node appears in the maximum layer, and every node is placed as close as possible to a source. Let's set the layering option property of our layered digraph layout to go.layereddigraphlayout.layerLongestPathSource, then reload the page. We see our source nodes, nodes without links entering them, alpha and zeta, are both in the maximum layer, the highest layer. All other nodes are as close to alpha or zeta as they can be. Layer optimal link length, the default layering option property value, assigns layers using optimal link length layering. With this option, nodes are placed into layers to minimize the total weighted link length. The length of a link between two nodes, A and B, is the layer of node A minus the layer of node B. Let's set the layering option property of our layered digraph layout to go.layereddigraphlayout.layeroptimallinklength, which, again, is the default value. Reload the page. We see nodes are arranged such that the lengths of links are as short as they can be. That's it for this video. To learn more about specific layouts, watch our Layouts video series. Each pre-built GoJS layout is explained in some depth. For even more information, you could visit the intro page on layouts or go explore the full documentation on gojs.net. Head over to gojs.net to see hundreds of samples, read more about GoJS features on the intro pages, or peruse the full API documentation. Sign up for an unlimited free trial, and you'll get 30 days of developer-to-developer support for free.